part of our Fort Nelson Reserve or our bottle fill. That's what I'm referring to. This package is available for $170. And Jim, what time slots do we have for today?
We have 11:30, 1, and 4:30.
So keep in mind, if you want this one, it'll be available to fill at 11:30, 1:30, and 4:30.
1:30, 1 o'clock.
Sorry,
11:31 and 4.
We're also selling our toasted rye with our US 1 rye, and that is available, I think, for about $2.05 after tax. It is one or the other. If you're interested in purchasing the package, you're going to see Jim. If you're interested in bottle fill or literally anything else, you'll see Dion and I at this other counter. Please go ahead and get your IDs out.
Going to go first, and what bat do you want to hold?
Okay, go. You can go first.
Oh my God, I don't...
We're Scottish and we're not.
That's okay.
Too familiar with the.
Is Johnny Bench? Is that? Is he, did he play at Wrigley Field?
He did. As a matter, he was a Cincinnati Red his entire career.
Oh.
You wanted somebody, a Cub that played at Wrigley Field?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, let's see. How about? Let's do Andre Dawson. Guys, these are all museum artifacts.
Who was Kennedy that played for? Was there a guy called Kennedy that played for Wrigley Field? I thought.
Don't remember who that was, but I vaguely remember. Yeah.
I'll Google it. Yeah, I'll Google it after I've done
Carl Ostrinski's grandson is playing for the Giants.
Okay.
Guys, these are all museum artifacts. We're only going to hold or touch them on the silicone.
Okay.
We're not going to touch or grab the wood.
Sure.
We're not going to tap the plate or swing, but we can.
Close,
yeah, there you go.
This is the second call
at
the 10:40
Bat
Factory Tour. If you have tickets for
the 10:40,
slide
your hands together so you look like a hitter. Now you got it.
Hey, bada bada bada, so wing, bada. Kennedy, 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 so wing, bada.
Hey, bada bada bada, so wing, bada. Kennedy, 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 so wing, bada.
So, what do you got, sir?
I'm going to go for Babe Ruth.
Well, of course.
Have to.
Yeah. This bat is 91 years old this year. 1933, yeah. It's also the heaviest one in this collection. It's 42 and a half ounces.
This is the third and now the final call for 10:40. If you have tickets for 10:40,
yeah,
please make your way to the Babe Museum Gallery and have those tickets ready to be checked. To find out where the tour group for 10:40 is meeting, please
make your way
to
the Babe Museum.
Baseball bat in your hand as a glass region. Bring something out that's inherently lying dormant in your jeans. Oh, fuck.
Chip.
Baseball bat unlocked.
tonight.
That's what we're seeing. We're on the guest list. We've got them up. Inside each one of those, there's a description of the whiskey.
Mm-hmm.
So you're going to get the look, the nose,
yep,
the finish, the taste and whatnot, but they're all on these little cards here. So nose, taste, and finish tells you the price. So if any of these, you know, really, yeah. And then they've got them available in flights
next door
inside the bar.
Fantastic.
So you can try before you buy.
Awesome. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. My pleasure.
Crazy. Is there something told us to get, you know, like one that was like too cheap?
1920 is like a famous one, and that's like apparently people go wild for that. I like that.
Twin Peaks. It looks like the,
yeah,
isn't it?
The, what are you talking about? The pot kettle? Yeah. Uh-huh. It's a pot still.
I know, but I just made that, yeah, what, for some reason that
Major Briggs.
Oh mate.
For a girl. Just wanted to leave it. Because it'll go from whiskey and then I'm like, who's that guy singing? In the background, the voice of an angel. You get your moment, mate.
Foreigner. The new album by Foreigner.
So we've got the barrel strength bourbon, we've got the rye, the port finish rye, oh no, not port finish rye, sorry, it is just rum cask finish, that's so you can see it. Yeah, so I've got those two. I also got the lock stock and one smoky cocktail. JP got the Lehimosa cocktail. And we're obviously at Angel's Envy.
What is that?
It's cherry. I'm going to try the rye first. Quite a distinct nose. Reminds me of carpet underlay. the rough side of a carpet.
Oh.
Rum finish, sugars, not as peppery as I expected, but that's my opinion on rye, it's not the case. Got the bourbon, this bourbon, it's not the standard bourbon, this is the single barrel bourbon rather than the standard bourbon. Is it good?
Quick finish to sweet. Yeah, it's good. High proof, easy drinker. A little bit of heat on the finish. Good. And now the cocktail. There we go. What you got? That's delicious. That is great. Well, JP, we're going to go to JP. He's got
his cocktail. What are we saying?
Well, I was ready for an orange cream soda, but I found myself drinking a La Hermosa, Angel's Envy Bourbon, Cinnamon and Mexican Chocolate Averna, Carpano Antica, Amaro Nonino Bitters Blend, created by David Castellon of the Misfit Lou and Hereafter. Hereafter? That's a probably right.
Yeah.
Oh, no way. Winner of Angel's Envy 2024 Manhattan competition, spelt wrong. Somebody's got a typo on the end. But yeah, let's go for it. Not as aggressive as I thought it was going to be. Really quite pleasant as the flavours like bounce around your mouth. And you can taste all of that in it. And I don't know anything about this.
Winner? Happy?
Yeah, but I'm still getting an orange cream soda.
Stars in your eyes.
evergreen liquors. I've just realised that I've videoed the entire shelves in slow motion, so hopefully that looks okay. This is overwhelming. I don't even know where to start. Don't know what to get. I will definitely be buying a bottle, but they have a bar. So let's get to the bar and get some tasting on the go. That sound good, JP?
Yeah, I've got my red cream soda.
So for him, we have Barrel Armida finished in pear brandy rum and Sicilian Amaro casks. It's a personal favorite of mine, and I think it's really great for people who aren't super into bourbon because it's got all those extra flavors going on. And it's not high proof.
Amazing.
Taste putting your tongue tingle, but it's not overwhelming. It's not gonna hurt you too much. It's not gonna punch you in the face. It's gonna go down very smoothly, very easily. It's gonna have all the oak notes to it. It's gonna have a little bit of tobacco, a little bit of vanilla in the finish. This is a fantastic drink.
So JP is gonna try this one here that we've recommended for us. And as you can see, very distinct cask finish.
And it works.
First one's for free. Go back in. I guess you're used to the alcohol.
Much better in the second.
Yeah. I feel like trick. The first one's like your tongue's not used to it. It's 57% alcohol you're having.
Yeah.
And you're like shocked.
And I took a bigger mouthful than I normally have done in previous tasting, but the second blast, it's really nice.
What you get?
It was quite fiery when it went down. I mean, we've not eaten lunch. it's a lot of flavour in it. Did you get that?
But I don't want to influence you. So.
No, I know. What flavours am I getting?
Yeah, what, go in again. What I do in that situation is I close my eyes and I see what pops into my head. It could be shapes, it could be colours, it could be flavours, it could be anything. Because it's hard, something that's hard to define what you're having.
Well, I mean, it says that it's in pear, brandy, rum, and Sicilian Amaro cask. You can definitely taste like a kind of brandy.
Yeah.
Like it doesn't taste to me like bourbon.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Like I kind of think I know what bourbon tastes like by now, and it doesn't. It says bourbon, but it doesn't taste like bourbon to me. It tastes more kind of.
Doesn't have the vanilla, doesn't have the sweet.
No, it doesn't have that. But it's.
When would you drink it? Could you drink that daily, or could you drink it after a meal, or would you drink it like as a nap, like as a nightcap?
I would say it's more of a nightcappy type thing.
Like a finish.
Yeah, it doesn't feel like something post meal. I mean, obviously people would do that, but like, I would say it's more like that. It definitely feels like a kind of. Adult drink.
An adult drink.
Yeah.
About time we acted like them. Right, so I've got the Nulu straight bourbon store pick. 55% proof. kind of hard to say what it is in terms of it's NGP bourbon, 46 years. It's a small batch. It's blended. It's good. It's not the worst thing I've had. It's not the best thing I've had. However, the gentleman behind the bar has recommended that we try the Nashville Barrel Company Stoke Pick.
This one here?
Yes.
But we're running out of time because we need to go to Michters. So. It's been the most manic 4 days of my life.
So this is their Stoke Pick. This is going to be a little bit sweeter, fruitier, light style bourbon. So you're going to have a dark versus a light.
Amazing. So this is Stoke Pick.
Yep.
This is standard.
Yep.
This is when the magic of editing comes in. Because I've done like 600 gigs so far of footage, and I'm like, it's great. And then I'm like, future David hates me right now.
It's $4.13 when you buy 2 packs, but this is a 30-cent off promo pack. So if you buy 2 packs,
Okay, I get a little bit more than this one.
And these ones are already 30 cents off individually. So this one's $4.32 by itself.
Okay. What about the cinnamon? The cinnamon lot of hunters.
Yeah, there's a lovely mouthfeel to it. Both of them.
Mine is three.
Try to get rid of it. Try to get my tongue back in the game.
No.
So what is the mash bill of them?
So it's going to be three different mash bills. Yeah. That's kind of our whole thing. It's bringing those, marrying them together. And it's one weeded bourbon that features like an organic red wheat. And then the other two are going to be rye based. So high corn. So it's a high corn, a high rye, and a wheated bourbon.
Right.
This is a negative balance.
So this one here is this one.
Yeah, that's the breakdown kind of all of our different blends.
So they'll take 300.
Yeah. Well,
how do you
tap in the glass, that's what I'm doing. You can't see it on camera because of the angle, but this is nice, but this is why I wanted the two, because
you get a cigarette?
I'm gonna give you a terrible tasting though. It's like a warm furry blanket, right? On the finish, it's like this warm, safe. Whereas this is more fruity, there's more like red fruit, there's more. I'm not even looking at the taste notes, but there's a sweetness there that's, instead of a warm blanket, it's more like a cocktail at the end of the night. I'm going to use a really, really wanky one. Not going to use that one. It just seems more fun. This seems more like winter by the... This is Gilmore Girls.
Okay.
This is Sex in the City.
There you go. Yeah.
Bet you never thought I'd say that. what's the retail?
This one is $73.
I'm going to buy that. This is exactly what I want to buy. I was coming here and people were going, oh, BTAC. You're not going to get any BTAC. You're not going to get any of this. And I was like, I'm not going to buy allocated bottles. I want to buy like something that I can only get from the ground and take back and share.
Yeah.
Oops. Get maple?
Yeah.
Thought you would.
The bottles. It's a binary area and we can't walk on the floor. And then right on the bricks, you'll put today's date. 2/24/24. Yeah.
So I'm from here.
Oh, right on.
All right, cool. So now what we're going to do is, we're going to, look at you. You drunk as you can really shake it. You need some water.
They ain't called nothing.
Are you sure? So now we're gonna take the sticker off and we're gonna put the label on the box. And when you do this, please do not smear the ink. Remember that. Alrighty. Now we're gonna fill these bottles up. So two people at a time, we'll attack you. Step on up, we do a single foul line. All right. My next two people step on up. You up to pull the levers up once they fill up. Give me a couple of seconds, I'll be right back.
First one's a freebie, you've got to the second one. That's what I tell him. Like first hit doesn't count.
No?
Go again.
First hit doesn't count?
Your tongue's not used to it. Second one's when it kicks in.
If I could need to have the coffee beans they had back there, you know, you need to clean your palate. There's so much flavor to it. Like it's very complex.
It's high proof as well. So you can add a little bit of water and bring it down, but it's...
Huh. So what is this?
It's the lady called Ardnamurchan.
What's it?
Ardnamurchan.
Ardnamurchan.
That's going to be very hard for Americans to say.
It's
you know that,
on
right?
A peninsula on the west coast of Scotland.
You should just call it Ardnam M.
We just call it Ardna.
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 Okay.
Short, because no one's good time to say Ardna market. It's for a whiskey YouTuber who's been doing it for years and years. He's an old cantankerous bastard. He could watch this video and hear me say that and he'd be going, aye. And he's done over 1,000 reviews of whiskey. And this was his fountain. It was a celebration of 1,000 reviews. And so he got a single barrel bottle. So it was like that. What you have in your hand is gold dust.
I mean, but what, like, I mean, a guy like that, right? I mean, he's so seasoned and he's tasted so much, right? For something for him to be like a treat or something that's out of the ordinary, I mean, it would have to have depth. It would have to have a little bit of everything, right?
The mouthfeel in that and the complexity to it is like what you're saying.
absolutely. Yeah, there's a lot going on, but you can sit with that in a glass for about an hour and just like keep going and going and going, right, I'm getting this. But the thing to remember is it's sherry, so it's a sherry cask, but it's peated spirit. So you've got that smoke, but you've got that red fruit.
Okay.
So use that as your guide and just kind of work through. But I can guarantee you, in the next year, we could try as many peated sherry bourbons. Nothing
won't be the same.
Nothing will be as good as that.
Interesting.
Nothing. Well, that's why I picked it to bring over here, because I was like, got to do the good shit. You got to represent. You can't do it bad.
Sort of smell the smell of
don't stop believing, guys. Don't stop believing.
What was
that? Unless the rain's down in Africa.
Some quiet conversation.
come with me on a journey of tartan. I'm Scottish.
Why is it called Tartan House?
Because when we go out and they go, hello.
Of course I'm playing Johnny. Of course I'm playing Johnny, sir. Did you know this was going to happen?
No.
Scott's whiskey blender. So Kentucky bourbon, but done in a slightly different style.
There's the Scotch one.
Diamond.
I know.
Yeah. I saw him live 5 times.